What a beautiful windmill. I wonder how I could make one that pretty. Hello everyone, welcome to another building tutorial. My name is Locke Rawls. Today we are on the Epic Quest build server, specifically the Plot World, and we're going to design a Nordic style windmill together. Now, I'm going to be completely honest with you. I did record this video first time live doing the tutorial as I was going. However, it didn't record the audio. And I was faced with the decision, do I redo the video and just do it again, or do I just record over it? And I figured it looked all right. I'm just going to record over it and I'm just going to try and do the tutorial now, watching the video with you guys. So we're going to start off. We're going to design the base of the house. To do that, we're going three at the front, then we're going to do an L shape, and then five on the sides. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then another L, and you should have something a little bit like that, an O shape. And then we're going to go around the sides, and we're going to place blocks on all of the corners. Just a cobblestone block on all of the corner pieces. What we don't want to do is we don't want to place it there. We want it on the corner, like so. Keep going round. And there we go. Should have something a little bit like that once you've completed. I'm just going to place stairs in between here. Just go around placing stairs in between all of the cobblestone. Made a bit of a mistake there. I'm not going to fix it till right at the end. And we're going to miss that one out. Oh no, we didn't. We missed that one out. Yeah. It's weird watching back on the video because you know all the mistakes you've made. Here I was deciding whether or not to use spruce wood or normal oak wood. I decided I was going to use oak purely for the simple fact that I've done oak for the rest of the builds, all of the Bree houses, all of Archet. Simple reason, if I want to use it in Middle Earth or anywhere near there, I want to use the same design, the same logs. But I do think spruce does look a bit better. If you want to make spruce instead, go for it. Just going around, placing logs. Yeah, I mean, likely we're going to use this somewhere on Middle Earth. I'm not really too sure where it's going to be. Possibly Bree, or one of the villages around the side of Bree. But I am placing it on the build world for now, as I'm not too sure where exactly we're going to place it. So now we're just going to place wall on all of the corner pieces. Just go around placing wall. There we go. And then we're going to place logs at the side, just creating a bit of detail and a bit of depth to it. Keep going round. There we go. Okay, and then just last bit of wall, going around making sure that we haven't made any mistakes anywhere to patch up. Nope, looking all right. And we're just gonna place stairs in between all of the logs. A bit more detail. Just going to do that all the way around. And there we go. Looking all right so far. So you should have something a little bit like that for the base. We're just going to add a bit more height. We're just going to go up 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. We're just going to go up 4 all the way around. Keep going up, just adding a bit more height into it. All of this here is going to be the base of the house. Sorry, not the house, the windmill. Although the way I've designed it is easily somewhere that someone can live as well. And then we're just going to go inwards after we've done the base. So we're just going to place a bit of wall and we're going to make a window. So you're just going to find a glass pane place a window in there, and we'll also have the same on the other side. We're going to place a few windows at the bottom as well. We're going to have a window there, and then on the sides we're going to use windows. This is going to be the front of the house, the entrance. We're not going to place a window there. Just go round like so. There we go. So at this point here, I wanted to do a window on the other side, just so we're keeping some consistency. There we go. This is going to be the front of the house. So as always, you want the front of the house looking better than the rest of it. We want as much detail all over the house, but the most amount of detail needs to be at the front. Just bear that in mind when you're making your house. The front is a bit that everyone's going to be looking at. Just going round, placing wall, creating some depth. Keep going round. More wall. More wall. Just want to reiterate, I say this in all of the building tutorial videos. It's great that you're watching tutorials to help you become better at building. However, you always want to add your own bit of creative flair into each of the maps that you try to recreate. There's no point following exactly what I do, otherwise you may have just downloaded the world and, you know, I mean, I don't really mind you doing that, but you're not really learning anything. And the idea of these videos is I want you to become better builders. So I'm just creating a window here. Just a window at the front of the house, similar to what we did in the Brie video, where we created a roof to the window. And then we're just going to try and find a slab and just place it underneath. Underneath all of the stair blocks. I'm just going to place it down so I can click on it later just to be able to get that block again. And there we go. So yeah, you always want to put a bit of your own creative flair onto each of the maps. It's a simple reason, else it's not really yours, to be honest. You haven't learnt anything. It's not really your own build. So yeah, you just want to try and just, you know, change something around. It doesn't really matter whether or not it's a case of you're just changing a little bit of the detail, you're changing some of the blocks over and using something, a different block entirely. Maybe you want to change the wall and use a different colour wall. So yeah, now I'm just going to add a bit of detail into the top bit. I've done the base and I'm going to have it going inwards. That's the sort of design I'm sort of trying to go for. So I'm just trying to create something on these sides here. I'm not really too happy with just having a flat design like I've done. So yeah, we'll just do something a little bit like that and then just place oak logs in there. And then I just want to place a stone brick in the middle there. I actually had a stone brick in my inventory, but never mind. And we're going to do the same on all of the other sides as well. And we're going to have it going slightly lower down than at the front and the back. So the sides are going to be just a block lower. Oh, what are we doing here? No, we're designing the windows instead. We thought that we want a bit more lighting on the side of the house. So we're just going to make a few windows. And we're going to need to do the same at the back. But first we're just going to change the height. There we go. Oh, we'll do the design that we talked about earlier. Trying to remember how I built it. Oh, it's a bit weird doing this. But you know, I'll remember for next time to make sure I'm recording the audio before recording a sort of a 40-minute video. We all live and learn. I'm sure I'll do an improvement than what I did first time around. Okay, so we've got that bit there. Just sort of thinking about how I'm going to do the rest of it, and more specifically the corners, these bits here, because the design I'm going to go for is I'm going to have this going inwards, so all of this is going to come in on itself. We're going to go a block inwards, we're going to go up, make a tower. It's going to look absolutely lovely. I'm sure it will, because I've already seen the final product. So we're just going to place these blocks in here, and we need to do the same on the other side. But before I can sort of work out how that's going to sort of work out, I'm going to need to do the roof on the window I did at the front. We want it to be consistent. We're going to go around and we're going to place a window. There we go. Same on the other side. And this is why I placed the block down earlier, so I could... wait a second. Place the rest of that there. And now, this is why I placed that block earlier, so I could fly over, collect that block, fly back, and I could place these bits here. Rather than going to my inventory, because, you know, I'm weird like that. Okay. So, that's the back of it done. Trying to work out the corner bit as well. I need that facing that way. There we go. And then we can go up here. Then I can place these blocks in here. Copy what I've did earlier. Have a bit of a wall. Put those logs down. Then the middle bit. Don't know why I did that. I could have just scrolled over. There we go. The back of it done. So now we just need to work on the side. Nothing really too difficult here. Block in the middle. Not too shabby. Did I not decide to copy the design on the back? Put the windows in? No, obviously not. Obviously I missed that bit out. Or I just did it later on in the video. So now I'm trying to work out how I want it going inwards. So I'm trying to design all of this here. Trying to think up of a design for this coming inwards, and I need to make sure that it's going to, you know, look good on the outside. So I'm placing all these logs here, making sure they come this far down. I'm going to be consistent. I'm going to do this on the other side bits as well. There we go. So we'll start at the same point. Oh. Making mistakes. Okay, now we're just going to add a bit of height to the tower. Just going to make a bit of a tower here. So we're just going to build up. Go round, just building up of our tower. As always though, I would really, really like to hear what you guys have in mind for what I can make in future videos, future tutorials, anything at all, anything that you'd like to see made in Minecraft. I mean, since I'm making Middle Earth and I've got a few projects we've got lined up, very likely that I'm going to be making a Hobbit Hole for a future video, and also a couple of the houses for Minas Tirith, as Minas Tirith is going to be quite a big project that I'm going to be working on, remaking all of Minas Tirith once again. Reason for that is we started a project in like 2011 when Minecraft was still very new, and since then there's been so many blocks added to the game. There's been quite a few people who have made, in all honesty, better versions of Minas Tirith. And we could do better. We really can. So we're going to. We're going to make an even better version of our Minas Tirith. I'm going to make a few of the houses for that. I'm going to make a tutorial for it as well. So right now what I'm doing is I'm just making a bit of a skeleton for the map. For the windmill. So I'm just roughly designing how I'm going to have it. This is just a template, really. I don't have to follow this. It's just I have a rough idea of the height that is going to be, everything like that. So we're actually going to add a bit more height to it, just another two blocks. And then what we want to do is we want it coming out slightly. We want a bit of a bulge, a final few blocks, and then we're going to do the roof on top. So I'm just going to get a few stairs to place this. As I said, it's just template at the moment. None of this is finite, but it's a rough idea of how I'm going to be having it later on. I mean, most builders actually do this from the start. I mean, I do like to build as I go, but I sort of realised halfway through doing this, it was too much of an ordeal to try and think how I'm going to do this as I was going around. So I just want a bit of a template, so I know that I'm going to be not going too far wrong. And that does help me. Oh, keep making a mistake there. And just place that last little block. Okay, so that's roughly how it's going to look. Okay, now we're just going to add a little bit more height into it. Just go a few, couple more blocks around. She don't like that at all. Should probably be wall there instead. We only really want those blocks there for the corner pieces. Just add a bit of height. Two, actually we go up three. Oh, I've only done two there. Go back round, place another one. And then we'll just do start on the roof. We're not going to do the entire roof. Not now, because we're going to be changing it later on. Actually, we don't need to do it at all, really. We're going to have the windmill actually coming out here. So these are where the blades are going to be. So the blades are going to be roughly there. So that's roughly how we're going to have it. Okay, so we've got our template done. Our skeleton is done. And now we can just work on this design here. So how we're going to design this bit of the house. We can work on that now. Just going to add in some wall on these sides. And then we're left with something a bit like a T shape. Now I'm just going to sort of play around with how I want the design to look. Just, you know, throwing a few ideas and trying a few things out. Tell me in the comments below whether or not you like this kind of tutorial where I've already done the build and I'm just re-recording over it after. Do you want me to do it live? Do you want me to try and record after over it? I mean, I could do both, really. It doesn't really make much difference to me. The benefit of doing it after is I know what I've done. I know the mistakes, and I could probably think about how I can sort of teach you what I'm doing a little bit better. I mean, if I knew that in mind, I would probably just build rather than play around with a few things. But yeah, tell me what sort of things you want. I don't think it really matters to me. So yeah, just tell me, what would you like to see? Would you like me to do it live and I'm talking to you as I go, like with the Brie House, or do you want a style like this? Just tell me what you want and I'll try and cater to that. So just filling in with a bit more wall. It's mainly wall for this build, so lots and lots of wall. And then just building this up here. Okay, and that is pretty much about done for that section. Oh no, it's not, we've just got half of it left to do. Placing some more wall. This is something I normally do when I'm building. I normally have to click on something to get that block again. I don't tend to keep things in my inventory for too long. I don't know how you particularly like to do it, whether or not you just have set blocks and then you go back and change them over and sort of change them around after. Okay, and then I want to get a slab and place that on the top there on all of those pieces. We don't really want the logs exposed. Just place them all the way around. And there we go. Right, so this looks a little bit fat. Looks a bit fat there. I think it would be better if we place two logs either side, just to, I don't know, make it look a bit skinnier. And then we could probably get rid of a bit of the height to the windmill as well. So we're probably going to do that in a second. Just place that in there to make the corner piece. We can get rid of that and make it look like so. So it'll be a bit thinner. We can probably get rid of a bit of the height because it's a bit thinner as well. And it'll make the roof of the windmill look a bit better as well, as there's more sort of depth to make it as well. So the roof is going to look as silly and it will just look better overall, just more detail as well. So get rid of that. Destroy that all the way up. And place in the logs. Place the logs. There we go. Nearly finished. Oh. There we go. Let's just place that there. Oh no. There we go. And on that side as well. Oh. There we go. Okay. Oh no, I still need this cooler left to do. Thought I'd done that. Okay, last bit. And that's that done. So now it looks a bit thinner, a bit slimmer. We can change the roof around as well. The roof looks a bit silly now. So we just place some wall in here. And we'll go back and add a bit of detail after. We're just going to place it in for the template now. Like so. And ta-da. So taking a bit more shape now, we sort of have a rough idea of how it's going to look at the end. We'll probably want to work on this bit now, change this over, just get rid of it completely, because we don't need that anymore. It was just a template, just a rough idea of how we're going to do the next bit of the windmill. We're just going to work on the last bit. We're going to have it extending out slightly. Otherwise, it'll look a bit silly just putting a roof on top now. Just have it extending out a little bit, and then we'll place the roof. So just going to go all the way around, placing the stairs. Have to do something with the corner after, but we'll come back to that. And then we'll just place, we'll go two up, or no, three up. All the way around. And there we go, just keep going around, keep placing those logs. Okay, and yeah, taking a bit of shape. So we're going to have this extending out. We're going to have to do something there, but I'm not really too sure what. Probably just put a slab there and sort of design what we want for the roof as well. It is quite difficult doing a roof like that. In fact, we'll go a block lower. We don't want it that high up. We'll just go two up, I think. Otherwise, it'll be too tall. So this is where the roof is going to be. We're just going to have it extending out before we start on the roof. Just mapping out how we want it. And then we can have this going in here. I do find it quite difficult to do these sorts of roofs. They're not very simple, to be honest. For me, it's just really a case of trial and error to try and make it look right. I just, you know, play around with a few things until it looks to my liking. So we're just going to want to try and find a slab we can put in there. We can never find it. There we go. Spruce wood slab. Place there. And yeah, we can just have that going there. To put them all the way around. Like so. And then we just place some wall in. Place it around. Like there. And there. Oh, missed it. There we go. Okay. Right. So now we just need to work on the roof. Because right now that looks a bit silly. So how are we going to do this? We could... it's quite tricky with these sorts of roofs. Put a slab in there. Could go like so. And then we could do something. This could maybe come in. Like that. Not too sure. Have that go in another block up. Get rid of those. Doesn't look right. We'll just do that all the way around. We'll just copy the design that we did there. Like that. Yep, that looks right. And we just do that all the way around on the other sides as well. Oh. There we go. And on this one. No, that's not right. Facing the wrong way. You have to go change that now. Ugh. Keep messing up. God, there we go. Okay, and there we go. So that's the base of the roof done. And we can just have this coming inwards now. So just trying to work out how we're going to bond this. Have this all coming in. So place them round like so. And we need to do something here. We can just go round and try and just do that. That'll be okay. And then we just need to do the top. We need to do something different for that. Otherwise it's just going to... let's just do one more block up here. Increase the height. As I said, for this, I'm just doing a lot of trial and error. And we'll just do corner pieces here. Just go around placing them. You can have this coming in. Like that. And then, just change the height of that to make it one block. And there we go. That's the roof done. It looks okay. We can change it later, but I'm reasonably happy with it. So now we need to work on the blades. So we'll change the height of that because we did lower the height earlier. So we just change it a block lower. And we can work on how we're going to have the blades designed. So we're going to use wool and logs. So we're just going to map out roughly where all the blades are going to be. Just making a cross. And then we'd have the blades, just roughly thinking about how I want it. So yeah, we'll do it like that, and then we'll do it all the way around in all four corners. So just design it once again, same as before. And then another blade. Oh, there we go. Yep, there we go. One more blade done. And do the same here. Grab some wool. Oh no, wrong side. Went over on that bit there. Okay. Last blade. And, oh, there we go. Now it's finally actually looking like a windmill as opposed to before when it was just a tower. But we want a bit more detail on this bit here. You could leave it now and you could be reasonably content, but I think it needs a bit more detail. So I'm just going around and I'm just placing some logs in here just so that we can liven it up a little bit. And then we can just place some stairs underneath that. Just to add a bit more detail, otherwise it's very, very plain and it just looks a bit boring to look at. Just liven it up a little bit by doing this. So that's that bit done. And then let's get some fences and place them on top. Just going around to placing some stairs. Okay. So we'll do the same up here. We can probably do this in a line with that blade, but probably be a bit too high up. So we'll do it a block lower. We'll just go around, place them, and then we can do some stairs here. So this is sort of as if we could move the blade in a way, even though we can't. And then we can do a bit more with the roof here. So we can just, do something a bit different here. We can try and, have this place a bit like that. Looks a bit more interesting now. And do that all the way around. Oh, there we go. That'll times I mess up. Yeah, there we go. Okay, and we could do the same on the front. But it's going to be touching the blade if we do. There's not really enough room to do it. But just try and put it in. And then we can't get underneath. We just have to fly under, come around. So even though this is going to be touching the actual blade of the windmill, we're just going to put it in anyway. just for the sake of it. Okay. I'm reasonably happy with that so far. And it's still not complete, and there's still a bit more detail we can put in. So what we'll do is we'll put a bit more detail into the bottom of the windmill. So we just and also we'll change the colour of the blades. We just put a bit of grey in, so it's not just one straight colour. Just change it around a little bit, like so. Just change a little bit of the colouring of it, liven it up a little bit. And there we go. And yeah, let's get. We'll just put a trapdoor in the middle there. Ta-da! Taking a bit more shape now. But as I said, we'll put a bit more detail into the bottom of the windmill. And to do that, we'll just get some cobblestone wall. If I can find it. Oh no, I want some fences. I've already got some cobblestone wall. And we'll just place them there. All the way around. Placing these. Keep going. Finally fixing that I missed out on. There we go. And that is just about finished. It's looking quite nice. I'm just trying to do a bit of an aerial shot now for you guys so you can see. So I ended up placing the windmill in Combe, one of the villages which I'm currently working on. I'm not going to show the map off to you at this point, purely because it's going to be saved for another video. The only differences I did make is I did want to place some cobblestone in here and add a few buttons as well as placing a bit of cobblestone up here and going around. That's the only difference I actually made to the windmill to place it into this world. Purely for the simple fact that all the houses around here have a lot of cobblestone and I wanted to try and keep it to the theme. I might make a couple of changes later on, but I think it fits into the world quite nicely. So thank you for watching the video. I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you learnt something, and hopefully you have a lovely windmill, even better, or if not just as good as mine. Thank you for watching.